people who have came close to dying. What were your last thoughts? I was stabbed in the neck by someone robbing my house. I totally thought I was going to die. I hate myself, but I begged the guy who stabbed me to stay because I didn't want to die alone. He said sorry and walked away. That fucking broke my heart. Thankfully, he called 911 for me. I remember having a piece of food lodged into my throat at a young age. I was standing there thinking, well, this is it, and I just accepted it. I really don't understand it because I am terrified of death, so I don't get how I just accepted it, but yeah. I'm so tired. I wish these doctors would let me sleep. Weirdly calmed. Mind went quiet. Everything slowed right the fuck down. Afterwards though, mind screamed. For what it's worth, car accident, 100 kilometers per hour, 270 degree spin in front of an 18-wheeler. Across two lanes, down the embankment and slid between two concrete drainage pipes. Could have been hit by the truck. Could have rolled. Could have hit the pipes, which would have crushed into me. I never got to have my own cat. I was 6 years old. In the hospital with mono and strep and being administered antibiotics that I was having a severe and violent allergic reaction to. Everything was slow and fading, and honestly I don't know how I'm still alive. Luck, I guess. I got my cat though. Nearly was run over in a town square when a car decided to go through it instead of around it, and went onto the sidewalk. First and only thing to come out of my mouth to my friend next to me before we dove out of the way. Well, that's not good. Well, fuck, car accident. Who is holding me underwater? I almost passed out. I didn't even know the kid. Had a stroke last year and was taken to the ER by my brother. The last thing I remember was asking him to take a picture of me with his phone, as I must look terrible. After I was admitted, I didn't remember anything other than dreams until late October, and days after I was admitted, when everything was a blank. They induced a coma so that my brain swelling would go down, and I was critical, so I presume I was pretty close to dying then. I thought I was having a drug overdose. I just remember thinking how disappointed my mom was going to be with me. I was in a fight and I didn't know I was stabbed in the liver and the lung. I walked away with my friend and collapsed in an alley. I remember bleeding out with calming waves of euphoria washing over me, and I thought, I've lived enough. I'm okay with this. I blacked out and woke up in the back of an ambulance with waves of immense pain assaulting my body. Dying isn't awful. Surviving is awful. I pictured my husband coming home to an empty house, and I desperately hoped people would reach out and make sure he was okay. Couldn't stand the thought of him being alone. A little over 10 years ago, I had the Widowmaker heart attack. I spent the first day in the hospital with a balloon pump assisting my heart to help me stay alive until they could perform the surgery the next day. They told my wife that my chances of surviving were only about 20%. I had the priest and family, the whole nine yards. In the morning, as they wheeled me into the operating room, I was doing the Monty Python bit and get the machine that goes ping in case the administrator comes by, with a surgical nurse who was also a MP fan. The look on the surgeon's face was priceless, and I was chuckling as I went under. My last thoughts were F.E.H. We got this. The surgeon later told me that I was the only patient in his entire career that came into his operating room laughing, but that my attitude may have been a large factor in my survival. I was 16 years old. I had my lower right wisdom tooth come in and it broke the tooth next to it. That caused an abscess, which led to an infection in my day bone. I was taken to the ER by my mother because she thought I had some sort of lockjaw because I couldn't open my mouth. It was so swollen. The doctor told her that I couldn't be treated there, and so I was ambulanced to another hospital an hour away. I remember slipping in and out consciousness, getting prepped for the surgery, and having my dad there. The last thing I remember thinking was that I didn't want to go yet. I would make so many people devastated if I died. I remember crying before, and my dad just calmed me down and told me he loved me. I recovered in the hospital for a month. Got a visit from my then boyfriend, now husband. Missed high school finals of that year, and was discharged on Christmas Eve. That's it. As I looked at the surface of the water, I couldn't reach. Fuck, am I having a heart attack? There's no way. I'm not thin enough for that. My thoughts as my heart went into palpitations due to severe electrolyte imbalance, BC of anorexia. Spoiler alert, I was thin enough. The doctor told me I could have dropped dead at any moment. Took me a while for recovery to click in, several hospitalizations, but 6 years later I'm doing pretty good for myself. Funny, for lack of a better word, story. When I was 10, my family went to Florida on vacation with some other extended family. There was a plan where my parents went back home, MA, a few days before my brother and I, so we could stay longer with my aunt and cousins. It was my first time traveling with just my older brother and my second time on a plane. The first being the trip there. Coming into Logan Airport, our airplane started to fall out of the sky. Quite literally. Apparently it only happened for about 3 to 5 seconds. But the pressure made the oxygen masks fall from the ceiling. I'd seen enough movies at that point to know that basically meant we were going to die. I was for sure crying and freaking out like everyone else on the aircraft. For sure the most frightening experience of my life. Bar none. But I distinctly remember thinking, I'm never going to get to finish my Age of Empires 2 campaign. So, a video game was ostensibly my last thought. God, why can't I breathe right now? Just wish I could breathe. Oh, I'm getting tired, anaphylactic shock. Each time. What the fuck? Ow. Son of a bitch. Ah, fuck, don't run me over. Me being run over by a car while on my motorcycle. Shit, wasn't the car that hit me white? Single quote. As I'm looking down at a car underneath me, I'd been hit hard enough I bounced up over the car that hit me and had enough air time to clear the second one. Props to the driver of the third vehicle. He must have stood on the damned brakes the moment he saw me, because he brought the cement truck to a stop before it got to me. Second time I was hit by a car as a pedestrian. I'm now much more careful crossing streets. Not that it's helped much. I seem to have a car magnet in my ass.
If you enjoyed this video, please check out our playlists full of similar content. Epic Eracast is like doom scrolling for your ears. Please like, share, and subscribe.